up of noble endeavors and a future legacy of a distinguished American leader and humanitarian. I thank the leadership of this center for hosting and providing me to honor an exemplary American whose commitment to leadership, governance, democracy, and human welfare has made a struggle. The U.S., a global giant, became a natural ally of our freedom fighters. Our independence benefited from the loyal support of celebrated American progressive leaders and iconic civil rights champions. The legacy of this early partnership, contribution of American jurist Thurgood Marshall, who hopefully I will see the place of his remains tomorrow, who helped in the writing of our first constitution and continues to define our political culture of debate, helping us navigate challenges and make necessary progress as a country. This collaboration, mustard seed of people-to-people collaboration in the form of the historic student airlift program initiated by President JFK, enabled hundreds of young Kenyans to pursue higher education in U.S. colleges and universities, equipping our cadre of well-educated and skilled leaders. These strategic and thoughtful interventions reflected our values and empowered our young nation to stand confidently on its own and forge a path that we celebrate even today. Let me say this. Tomorrow, we expand this historic collaboration with five Kenyan universities signing a student program with their American counterparts to celebrate our shared progress and broaden the knowledge horizon and experience of both Kenyan and American. We have never looked back, neither in our determined quest to implement ambitious development programs, nor in our commitment. We continue on a path of an open society, strongly committed to greater accountability and transparency, with robust engagement of civil society organizations who serve as a catalyst for societal progress, amplifying the voice of the people and ensuring their governance. As a fundamental component and watchdog of our civic space, the media in Kenya international ensures that our informed citizenry is the backbone of our democracy, driving development, open government. Recognizing that accountability and integrity are essential for enhancing democratic governance, expectations around social services and attendant opportunities into fundamental rights, while responsive and accountable government as both a state obligation and also a citizen's right. The people of Kenya are the ultimate holders of all sovereign power. Leaders like myself and many seated here have an irrevocable covenant to return to the ballot every 5 years. It was particularly very interesting. There was a narrative that had been weaved that the elections will be decided by something called the deep state and the system. But to me, if the deep state was to decide or the system was to decide, a different person would be standing before you today as president of Kenya. It is the people of Kenya who decided. Over time, our Election Management Commission has gained significant capacity and legitimacy as an impartial arbiter, steadily building voter confidence. Transparent election processes, including the use of electronic systems for voter registration, election validation, and results transmission, ensure the integrity of elections, making every vote count and every voice to be heard. We are ready to share our experiences in this space, even with the United States. To further ensure electoral integrity a comprehensive, predictable constitutional framework exists for election dispute resolution. Notably, the Supreme Court has resolved disputes four times, including annulment of the 2017 election, in which I was a candidate. Not your election is annulled, but it is democracy, and we choose to respect. It is quite a billion voters in 90 countries, including the United States and 18 African nations, will go to the polls. Importantly, this robust democratic engagement counters a growing, not-so-true wave of narrow nationalism, intolerance, targeting of minorities, violent political contests, and other anti-democratic tendencies. In several countries, we have seen unconstitutional changes of government that have threatened democratic gains. Consequently, this is a crucial time for reflecting on the need to strengthen democracy worldwide. Many countries are in economic and debt distress occasioned by climate change and compounded by an unjust international financial architecture and also an imperfect multilateralism. We now run the escalating risk of democracy and free markets being associated with poverty and suffering, lending credence to the white democracy is or has been on the retreat in many parts of the world, including Africa. Later this week, I will have the privilege to engage with members of the American Congress, and I'm happy one of them is here, to make a case for many countries in Africa, including Kenya, seeking a just international financial architecture that will afford every developing country concessionary development financing to support our economies, build resilience against the effects of climate change, economy, and energize our democratic enterprise. Kenya hosted the World Bank's AIDA 21 Replacement Summit 3 weeks ago, bringing together the African continent and the World Bank to urge our development partners, led by our friends, the United States of America, to enhance their contribution to the concessional window of the World Bank so that we can support developing countries. I believe the United States of America has a historic opportunity to lead the free world in dealing with this economic situation and give meaning to democracy and free market economy worldwide, including in Kenya and many other developing countries. Needless to say, it is a busy period for the Keter Center, intertwined with the overall well-being of humanity. In this context, Kenya has been and will continue to be a leader in the search for sustainable solutions to regional and global challenges. The war in Ukraine, the conflict in the Middle East, the fighting in Sudan, South Sudan, Eastern DRC, the Sahel, and terrorism in Somalia all demand cooperation and strategic global leadership. Kenya is leading the institutional reform of the African Union to enhance its role in economic development, peace and security, and stability across Africa, and foster infrastructure development. The United States of America has a significant opportunity to collaborate with Kenya and the broader African continent in building the institutional capabilities necessary for economic prosperity, peace and security for the 1.4 billion people living.
Thank you. That was wonderful. Thank you for all the lovely things you said about the Carter Center and about